there, hi there, ho there, everyone. It's time for the Mickey Mouse Musical Review. Before our main show begins, step into the pre-show theater to take a brief look at Mickey's career and see how it all began.
Mickey's story really begins in 1925 in this tiny garage in Hollywood where Walt Disney created Mickey's ancestors, the nameless little mice that first appeared in his Alice cartoons. 3 years later, Walt is desperately trying to come up with a new cartoon character. Here's Walt's own story of how it happened.
I was in New York at the time. I'd been producing a series of pictures for a company there. They were about a rabbit called Oswald, but I lost. Took it away from me, so I was all alone and had nothing. And Mrs. Disney and I were coming back from New York on the train, and I had to have something. I said, by the time I get to Hollywood, I must have something to... I can't tell them I've lost Oswald. So I had this mouse in the back of my head, because a mouse is a sort of a sympathetic character, in spite of the fact that everybody's frightened of a mouse, including myself.
So Mickey Mouse was born. But he was not an overnight success. Then in 1928... the introduction of sound changed everything. Now Mickey could have a full orchestra behind him when he made the first synchronized sound cartoon, Steamboat Willie. The recording musicians followed this crude beat pattern projected on the studio wall. Well, Steamboat Willie was a sensation. Mickey and his boss became front page news. Mickey Mouse speaks. The whole world applauded when Mickey finally decided to say a few well-chosen words.
I can't play.
Mickey Mouse had now arrived. His great moment came in 1932, when all of Hollywood turned out to present Mickey with his first Academy Award. What a thrill for a little mouse to be congratulated by the biggest stars in Hollywood. Mickey was only 4 years old, the youngest star ever to receive an Oscar. His youthful bosses, Walt and his brother Roy, pose with their new protege. That garage where Mickey got his big break into show business is a long way from the Disney studio of today.
I only hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me? M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Hey there, hi there, ho there, you're as welcome as can be.
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
The doors to your right will automatically open. Please choose an aisle and move all the way down to the far end of the row, filling in every available seat. During the performance, Mickey and his friends kindly ask that there be no eating, drinking, or flash photography. Thank you, and now enjoy the Mickey Mouse Musical Review.
One, two, three, four.
To sing.
I chased a polecat up a tree way out upon a limb, and when he got the best of me, I got the worst of him.
Oh, hum, the tune is done, the words don't mean a thing. Isn't this a silly song for anyone to sing? Oh, lay,
the tulips, and the sun is like a toy balloon. There are gathered in the morning glories in the golden afternoon. There are dizzy daffodils on the hillside. Strings of violets are all in tune. Tiger lilies love the
Caballeros, three gay caballeros, they say we are birds of a feather. We're happy amigos, no matter where he goes. The one, two, and three goes, we're always together. Oh, we have the stars to guide us. Guitars here beside us to play as we go. We sing and we samba, we shout, ay caramba. What means ay caramba? Oh yes, I don't know. Oh, through fair or stormy weather, we stand close together, like books on a shelf.
good pals though we may be, when some Latin baby says yes, no, or maybe, each man for himself.
Satisfaction, zippity-doo-dah, zippity-yay.